over there.
Can we see it?
Yeah. Yep, you're in it. You're completely in it. It's centered, so if I sit here in court, it gets you as well.
Excellent. Well, Adrian was nice enough to invest in an adapter so we can now run this guitar through his surround sound.
A couple of the movies that kind of influenced us growing up were three really good movies that come to mind as well. You've got Apocalypse Now, and you've got The Thing, John Carpenter's The Thing, the one that came out in the early 80s, and also another movie, the Ridley Scott film Blade Runner, and some of the closing music were these just really, really basic, powerful, simple guitar riffs that consist of maybe like two notes or something like that. So, you know, Tony threw together something on his guitar, so we're going to record it and put it into the closing credits. So it's kind of like giving out hats off to movies, you know, like, you know, The Thing and Apocalypse Now and films like that.
It's so, an homage.
An homage, yes. So let's go ahead.
Can we practice a few takes first before we actually record it?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So we're starting out on a low G note here. And you said you want to start low and go up an octave?
Yeah.
Okay, here goes. I think we're going to record from the speaker here. So let's move that over. Ready?
I'm ready.
I think I hit it a little hard that time.
Yeah. So,
just a little softer. Is that one good?
Yeah.
Still too tight. I'm turn these down a little bit. Just turn the bass down slightly. Actually in the speaker. It's up to you.
That's right.
Close, but it wasn't quite right, and I just had a little bit of twangy from the string vibrating. I think I can get it right this time, though. And then when you get the right the right take. Can you repeat it and loop it in your computer, or do you want me to do it a few times to get it right? Like,
I do it a few times.
How many do you want in a row? Like 5, 6?
Let's do like 6, yeah.
Okay.
What happens, because I know when you play Bela Lugosi, and you run your fingers run down the string.
It's called a slide.
Yeah, slide. Can you try that?
Yeah.
But how about when you go with the first, the low note, the lowest note?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you want me to drop it from the higher note back down low?
And then, and then slowly come up, and then, and then run back down again.
So you want me to slide up and slide down?
Yeah, yeah.
Just try it?
Yeah.
Again?
Nah, let's try without it then. Let's do without it.
I can go, or I can do low, and then jump to the second note.
Go for it.
And then slide down.
Try that. Let's just hear what it sounds like. Do without it. Do without it.
I think simple is better.
Yeah, keep it simple. Okay.
Okay, this will be the right take right here.
Okay. Can I put the speaker right up to that? Okay. Go for it. Let's just do 5 seconds.
Is it going to pick up all the walking around and then we've got clocks going? Is it going to pick up all that stuff?
No, I don't think so.
Do what now?
Let's just do 5 seconds in between each.
Okay.
Each hit.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Because then I have to cut the note off and it just sounds more too abrupt. But okay. You ready?
Let's do it again. Instead of stopping the key, you're letting it continue to run like when you hit the other key.
Mm-hmm. Do what now?
Because you're waiting 6 seconds and then you're stopping it and then you're hitting the other one. Just hit it, let it run out, and then after 6 seconds, hit the other one without having to stop the other one.
Okay. It's just within 5 or 6 seconds, the string is still vibrating, so I have to cut it off. So
let's just try and see what happens.
try letting the note run all the way out.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's going to be more like 10 seconds each note.
But that's okay. But let it run out, and then you're going to hit it again regardless.
The same note or the next note?
You hit the low note first.
Okay.
Okay. Wait 6 seconds. Mm-hmm. Let it run regardless. Hit the other note. Wait
but
6 seconds.
But see, I'm playing the notes all on the same string, so I can't play two notes at the same time.
So
if I play the first note and then jump to the second one, it's cutting off the first one. Mm. Because the next string is like an octave up. So.
Mm, okay.
Right. Unless you're like this one. And you're getting twice as much bass at the same time, and that's why it sounds kind of warped right now.
Yeah. Okay.
So, I mean, in my opinion, I mean, I like it just to let the note run out, even if it takes 10 seconds. It sounds kind of cool, where it slowly fades away, and then the next note comes in.
Okay.
And I mean, it's a spooky movie, and it has a spooky ending, and that's kind of what it's going to give it. But
all right, let's do that then. Yeah. Ready? Go for it.
I think that was a good one.
Yeah, let's learn. Go for it. Oh yeah, you can hear this freaking clock.
That's what I was afraid of. You sure that won't kind of sound cool then? Let's try it both ways.
Try both ways.
I can turn the clock off. Because I know that sensitive picks up everything. We'll do the same exact thing without the clock.
Yeah. Okay. I should put the clock in my room. I can still hear it. But yeah, we'll try it both ways.
I took the battery out, so there's...
Oh, so I can still hear.
It's just in your head, man.
Huh. Easy.
COVID.